normal force or normal reaction. Normal reactions. So the force normal to the surface. For this I am going to tell about say let us one block is there like this. Okay, the force normal to the surface is called normal force. So the force normal to the surface is called normal force. So normal force are normal reactions. Okay, now I am considering an object, suppose the horizontal surface I am considering. This is the horizontal surface. This is horizontal surface. Okay. This total horizontal surface is there, and the horizontal surface one body is there. Okay, downwards which force is acting? Gravitational force is acting, that is mg. Okay, this surface above one force is acting. Let us take one textbook. Okay, let us take this one. What is this marker is there? It is in my hand. Suppose, so the if my hand is not there, what happen? What would happen here? The pen, the marker should fall on the ground. So what happen here down? So the if surface is, whether surface is there or not, automatically the force will be exist. So if due to the surface, due to my hand or due to the surface, the marker is not coming to down. Even whether even the gravitational force pulls down also, the this marker is not coming down. Okay, against the gravitational force, another force, which one? The surface is giving another force. The gravitational force is downside, the surface is giving another force to this marker. Due to that, the marker is not coming to down. That force we are calling, that is the normal force. See here, this mg downside will be there, this, or else we can take textbook. Let us take one textbook, keep on the table. Okay, is it falling down? No. Why it is not falling down? Okay, surface is, what is the surface? Table surface is there. Okay, then you put, even table is also there, then gravitational force acting down, due to that it has to come down. Why it won't come down? Why? Because the surface is supporting to the textbook. The surface is giving some, surface is inside some force into the textbook. That force we are calling, or that force we are calling normal reactions or normal force. Okay, when in these situations, what happen in this situation? The body will be at the rest position only. Force is directly proportional to the normal reactions. Okay, even if you apply force also, it won't come back. So what happened? What I said here? Normal. The force is directly proportional to the normal reaction. Now, from the definition, what we can write? The force is directly proportional to the normal action. So here simple one definition is there. The force is directly proportional to the normal reaction. So what is it? Force is there. Which one? That is small f. Next, normal reaction, what is the letter? N. So what I can write here? F proportional N. Okay, if more force I apply, what happen? The more normal reaction will be there. So if I remove that proportional constant. Now I am going to remove that proportional constant. Then we can write this is the N, where F is the force, N is the normal reaction or normal force, then mu, then coefficient of where F is the force, N is the normal reaction, mu is the coefficient of friction. Always we are taking the coefficient of friction, mu we are taking. Okay, previously already I said about the different types of frictions. First one is statistic friction, second one is kinematic friction, third one is rolling frictions. Next we are going to see about that coefficient of first. So from this what we can write here, F is equal to what we can write. Suppose if I want to the definition, one what we can write, if I want to coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction, what we can write, tell me here, then F by N. So then what we can say the definition from this formula, we can tell about the definition. See, what is this coefficient of friction? So coefficient of friction is equal to what we can write, F by N. What is the F here? Frictional force. What is the down is there? Normal force. Then what we can tell about the definition means the ratio difference between force and normal reaction, then we can say that is the coefficient of friction. First one, what is the coefficient of friction? The ratio difference between force, which letter we are denoting? F. Normal reaction, which letter? Capital N. Then coefficient of friction, which letter? This is F. So simply you have to remember the small f by capital N. Then what we can say? That is mu. What is the mu means? Coefficient of friction. So next we can tell about the there are three types of frictions will be exist. Coefficient of statistic friction. Next, coefficient of kinetic friction. Next one. Same, what will be there? Coefficient will be same as it is in this place. First one, statistic friction. Next one, kinematic friction. Next, third one is rolling friction. We'll see what are those, what are the coefficients of different frictions. We'll write the formulas. Coefficient of statistic friction, first one. Coefficient of statistic friction. Okay, the ratio difference between the force and normal reaction, then we are calling that is the coefficient of statistic friction. The ratio difference between force and normal reaction is called the ratio difference between force. Which force? Statistic force. The ratio difference between statistic force and normal reactions is called coefficient of statistic friction, or else we can say statistic friction of coefficient also we can say. Then what we can write here, which letter we are denoting? Mu, statistic friction, S letter is there. Then what we can write here? Fs by N. Like this we can write. What is that? What is the first derivation? Statistic friction coefficient. Or else we can say like this also we can say statistic friction coefficient. Okay, statistic friction coefficient, which letter we are denoting? Mu s. Mu s is equal, what is the formula? The ratio difference statistic force and normal reactions or normal force is called statistic friction coefficient. Okay, this is the first one. Next one, I am going to tell about the next one. What is the next one? Kinematic 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 friction coefficient. Here which letter? Mu s. Next, here kinematic mu k. Another name also is there, the kinematic friction, that is the dynamic friction also we can say that is. So same thing will be there. So the ratio difference between, what is the here? Kinematic force and normal reaction. Then we can say that is the statistic friction of coefficient. Then what we can write? Mu k is equal to next F k by next n. This is the formula for kinematic frictions. So what is this? F k means kinetic force and normal reaction. The ratio difference between kinetic force and normal reaction, then we are calling that is the kinematic friction coefficient. Next, third one. Similarly, we can write third one. What we can write? What is the third one? Next, rolling friction. Rolling friction coefficient. Rolling friction coefficient, which letter we are denoting? Mu r. Then what we can write formula? Mu r is equal to, what is the rolling force? Rolling, see, that's why rolling force by n. The ratio difference between, by seeing the formula only we can tell the definition. The ratio difference between rolling force divided by the normal force, or else the ratio difference between rolling force and normal reaction, we are calling that is the rolling friction coefficient, that is denoted by mu r. Okay, what is the first one? Statistic friction coefficient, that is denoted by mu s. Next, kinetic friction coefficient, that is denoted by mu k. Next, third one is rolling friction coefficient, that is denoted by mu r. Like this, there are types of frictions and coefficients of frictions also will be exist. Okay, now we can observe. Suppose if I there will be horizontal plane will be there a vertical plane will be there inclined plane will be there. So sometime the, suppose if I take the ball and if I throw on, if I left the ball on the floor, what happened? The ball will move. So it is moving means what happened? Simply we can say that is the rolling. Then the rolling means what? We can say that is the rolling friction. Then further also we can derive the coefficient. Then we can say that is the rolling friction of coefficients. Next, kinematic. Kinematics means, suppose let us take the slanted or inclined plane, then keep one object on that, then what happens? Simply it is coming to down. There we can get that coefficient. What is that coefficient? Means kinematic friction. Let us take, then horizontal plane is there, then in that there in, with, at that point you are getting the statistic friction. Like this, that normal force or normal reactions, afterwards these coefficients will be exist, especially mu s first one, next mu k second one, and then mu r is the third one.